Hey everyone, it's Caitlin from Caitlin's Crafts. So, before we start talking about anything right now, I need to tell you that I'm very, very sorry that I haven't recorded. It's because, you know, school started last week for me, and it's kind of been a bit crazy with school, you know, and how all of my stuff I have to do, like chores and stuff, so it's kind of gotten a bit crazy. And I bet you're wondering, like, why do we just have to stare at this blank, boring thing? It's because today is not a tutorial for clay, rainbow, and pearl beads, anything. Or duct tape. I'm just going to be showing you all my clay stuff. So I'm going to show you my actual clay, like my colors and everything, and all my tools and all that stuff. So I'll gather up all my stuff, and then I will show you. I turned my lamp off for this one, but this is my first one. I have two of them. They're actually a bit lighter than they look, like right here. Like, you could kind of tell a bit better there, but they're, like, brighter, not really that much lighter, but they're really light. And the color it says is sunshine, and that's what they both are. They're the exact same. And I got two of them because I'm going to try to make a whole bunch of candy corn out of clay. So then I have this pink, and those are almost the same, but this pink, and then I have this color right here. This is called hot pink, and it's really cute. So then I have purple, more purple, this one's a bit darker, like just a reddish pink. Another yellow, green. This green has sparkles in it. I think you can tell right there. This Fimo Soft, and the name of it is Raspberry. I don't really like it because it's not actually soft, although the name's soft. This pink, which is called Ballerina, it's a really light pink, and I'm going to make a pig with it. A glittery black. A white with little specks in them. Like a granite one. Which is, like, pretty much these are the same. This one's just a bit more granite than this. Oops. This blue, which is called Blue Glitter. Pink. Sparkly red, if you can even tell. Yellow. Blue. And sparkly blue. So then, and purple. So then I have black, gray, and black. I actually think this one might be like a dark brown. I'm not really sure. Blue and brown. White. Blue, and then just some already cooked black. Green and purple. Blue and blue. Brown and a dark brown. Pink and red. This is one of the Fimo Softs. It has to be in its own thing because I had to use clay softener on it. And it really wasn't good, but it's like a teal, actually. Red and orange. And finally, yellow. I'm going to put all this away, and then I will show you the next stuff. Okay, so I'm going to show you my cutters, and then tools, and then just, like, my other random stuff. So, I have a ton of both of them. So, I have this cutter, which is a square, and at the ends, like, they're all like that. And this one's pretty cool. I haven't used it yet, because I just got it. This one's a circle of the exact same kind. A triangle where it's all is like that. Like, it looks kind of like a little thought bubble or something, but it's like an oval, kind of. A heart. Whoops. Sorry, dropped it. A rectangle. And that's all with the little weird shaped ones. And then I just have a normal rectangle, and these ones are like really small. A little diamond leaf type thing. A diamond. A little teardrop or raindrop. A square. A star. Like a little flower type one. Whatever this is, like, I don't really know. It's like an oval, I guess. Another little teardrop. A circle. A heart. And a triangle. And then I have little plastic ones, which came in like a Crayola one, so it was a bit for more like little kids that can't use metal ones. And this one's just a circle, a star, and a heart. And then I have this like variety of circles. They're all just metal circles. And then I have these, which might be circles, like to cut circles in, but I don't really know what they're for, so I'm just gonna go with circle cutters. Okay, so I have more tools than you can imagine next to me, so I'm gonna try to go through them a bit quicker. This is a little like poking needle tool and like a little scraping one. Another needle tool. Whatever this is, like to make little indents or something. Whatever you would call this, like it kind of looks like to be able to scrape it off your ground, your surface, and whatever this is again. Three dotting tools in all different sizes, a small, medium, and big. And then at the ends, they have like a little scraping and pretty like at points. Another needle tool and a little scraping tool. Honestly, I have no idea what these are. Little screwing tools. These, once again, I have no idea. Like, that's pretty weird. Focus. There we go. It's pretty weird to me. I have this one, which is like a little one to feather it or something. Along with this one, it's pretty much the same, just rub it up against the clay. Another one of those tools with a really weird bottom. An X-Acto knife, which has like three little settings, like so it'll come out a little bit. Or I didn't even have it on. There we go. So it'll go out all the way or be shut. Cutting tool. Cutting tool. Whatever these are. A clay blade. And a rolling pin. Which I think those little circle ones go on the bottom like that or something, but I don't know. Honestly. So we're down to the last four items. I have TLS, which is translucent liquid Sculpey. I have gloss glaze. So try to focus this up here better. I have satin glaze. And then simply some eye pins. So, one more second. I just keep it all in this little container, like it's just purple on the outside. It's pretty small, but I just keep it all in here. So yeah, that was all of it. I put all of this back so you can see. I'll put my clay back too. Okay, so that was all of my clay stuff. That was every single thing I have, and it kind of looks really cool like that. But I hope you enjoyed this. I mean, it wasn't really a tutorial, and I know that tutorials are better than just looking at all of my clay stuff. But I definitely will be having a tutorial up again soon. I just made something, and I'll give you guys a little sneak peek. It's with clay, I mean, not clay, sorry, hot glue and perler beads. So hopefully if there's anybody out there who loves clay and hot, I keep saying clay, sorry, perler beads and hot glue, that's a good one for you. And that rhymed. But I know that it was pretty fun to make, and that'll be my next tutorial, but I haven't really 100% finished it yet, so I decided I'd do this and show you all this before that, because I needed to get a tutorial up tonight. So I will, yeah, have that up soon. I hope everybody has a good day and a good weekend, since tomorrow's Friday. Yay, finally. And I'll see you guys in my next tutorial. Bye.